Dear brothers and sisters, we welcome you to the groundbreaking ceremony for the Heber Valley, Utah Temple of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. We're grateful for the participation of those joining us here on this site and for others joining us through technology. We are pleased to recognize our beloved prophet, President Russell M. Nelson, who presides over this ceremony. President Nelson is accompanied by his wife, Sister Wendy Nelson. I am Elder Kevin Duncan, General Authority 70 and Executive Director of the Temple Department, and I'm here with my wife, Nancy. President Nelson has asked that I conduct these services. We recognize other church leaders, interfaith, government, and education leaders. We extend our appreciation to those who have served on the groundbreaking committee as volunteers or in other capacities in the planning and preparation of this event. We especially thank the local groundbreaking committee coordinators, Brother Ron and Sister Debbie Benyon. We will begin this afternoon with an invocation offered by Sister Debbie Benyon.
Our dear Father in heaven, we come before thee with humble and grateful hearts this day that we can be here to participate in dedicating this ground, that it will be holy and sacred in preparation for a temple. We're so grateful for the sunshine, and we're grateful to be in the midst of thy living prophet and seer and revelator. And we pray for him and his wife and family that they may be strengthened and renewed. We're grateful and mindful of the pioneers who came to this valley and forged the way for us. And we pray that we can follow them in their faith-filled footsteps. We pray at this time for an extra blessing of peace and love and forging of friendships within this valley. Now we ask that thou wilt prepare our hearts and that we might be able to feel the Spirit, even the Holy Ghost, and abiding with us today. We are grateful for thy Son, for his redeeming sacrifice, and for the covenants and ordinances made available to us in his temples, that we might stay on the covenant path. We are grateful to be part of this gathering of Israel, and with these things we thank thee and say this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
I've been asked by President Nelson to share a few remarks. After my message, a choir comprised of youth from within the Temple District will sing On This Day of Joy and Gladness, conducted by Brother Stephen Reynolds. Since the beginning of this dispensation, groundbreaking ceremonies for temples have been a part of the history of the Church. The first temple location revealed to Joseph Smith was in Independence, Missouri. By revelation, the Lord identified the spot for the temple and commanded that the land be consecrated and dedicated. To fulfill the Lord's command, a prayer and symbolic turning of the soil commences the construction of each new temple. As we now celebrate the commencement of a new temple today, let us remember the reason that we build these sacred houses of the Lord. It is so that we can make sacred covenants with our Heavenly Father and receive priesthood ordinances that will bind us to Him and to the Savior, Jesus Christ, forever. This truth was reinforced to me earlier this year. Just prior to the rededication of the Tokyo, Japan Temple, many guests came to visit that temple. One such tour included a thoughtful religious leader from another faith. We taught our guests about Heavenly Father's plan of happiness, Jesus Christ's supreme role in that plan, and the doctrine that the entire family of God is being united and bound together through the sealing ordinance. At the conclusion of the tour, I invited our friend to share his feelings. In reference to the uniting of families, both past, present, and future, that good man asked in all sincerity, "Do the members of your faith truly understand just how profound this doctrine is?" And then he added, "This may well be one of the only teachings that can unite this world that is so divided." What a powerful observation. This man was not moved simply by the exquisite craftsmanship of the temple, but rather by the stunning and profound doctrine that families are united and bound to Heavenly Father and Jesus Christ forever. We should not be surprised when even someone not of our faith recognizes the majesty and beauty of that doctrine that is taught in the temples. What could become common or routine for some is oftentimes seen in its splendor and majesty by others who hear it or feel it for the very first time. The prophet Joseph Smith taught, quote, "When a seal is put upon the father and mother, it secures their posterity so they cannot be lost," end quote. To be clear, this seal does not replace the need for the redeeming power of the atonement of Jesus Christ upon a repentant heart. But this seal does offer a hope-filled bond with God. President Russell M. Nelson has taught, "Once we make a covenant with God, we leave neutral ground forever. God will not abandon his relationship with those who have forged such a bond with him. He will never tire in his efforts to help us, and we will never exhaust his merciful patience with us." What a profound message of hope that is for all of us on both sides of the veil. The prophet Joseph Smith described this joy when he said, "Now what do we hear in the gospel which we have received? A voice of gladness, a voice of mercy from heaven, a voice of truth out of the earth, glad tidings for the dead, a voice of gladness for the living and the dead, glad tidings of great joy." This temple will be a place of joy and strength for each of you. President Nelson has said, "Those who keep their covenants with God will become a strain of sin-resistant souls. Those who keep their covenants will have the strength to resist the constant influence of the world." Brothers and sisters, these truly are tidings of great joy. As you come to the temple, may your love for Heavenly Father, for His Son Jesus Christ, and for your family increase. May you be protected from the temptations of the world. It is my hope and prayer that each of us will feel these profound feelings of joy and gladness. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Joy and gladness, Lord, we praise thy holy name.
It is now our privilege to hear from our prophet, President Russell M. Nelson. After his message, President Nelson will offer the prayer dedicating this site for the construction of a sacred temple, which will officially conclude our meeting today. After the prayer is concluded, we invite you to remain seated as we proceed with the turning of the soil. After President and Sister Nelson have taken their place to turn the soil, we invite those who have been invited to participate in the first soil rotation to come forward. After the turning of the soil has been completed, we ask that you please rise and remain standing as President and Sister Nelson depart. After they have exited, others will be invited to come forward and participate in the turning of the soil. Thank you very much, brothers and sisters, for being here this day. We will now hear from our beloved prophet, President Russell M. Nelson.
Well, dear brothers and sisters, Wendy and I are truly grateful for this opportunity to be with you. We are very thankful to share this historic event with Elder Kevin R. Duncan and his dear wife, Nancy. Gratefully, we recognize the presence of church, educational, state, county, city officials. We thank each of you for attending this groundbreaking ceremony today. I just wish I could shake hands with each one of you and hear your name and your place and get to know and love you. But you'll have to just do it vicariously, I know. COVID style. Pioneer saints in Salt Lake Valley first contemplated settling Heber Valley on the Wasatch Back in the early 1850s. But they lacked a wagon road through either Parley's Canyon or Provo Canyon. Brigham Young called on Latter-day Saints to establish a road from Provo to Heber Valley in June 1858. The road was completed either in late 1858 or early 1859. Heber Valley was thus originally settled by members of The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. The Saints named their settlement after President Heber C. Kimball, first counselor in the first presidency. It is believed that he, President Kimball, had converted many of the earliest settlers of Heber while on his mission to England in the 1840s. Over the next decades, many Latter-day Saints arrived in Heber and Midway. In 1860, the Heber Ward was created. In 1877, the Wasatch Stake was created, with headquarters in Heber. The local saints began construction of the Wasatch Stake Tabernacle in 1887. Sandstone for that building was quarried east of Heber. The building was dedicated in May 1889. Well, meanwhile, many converts to the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints came from Switzerland to reside in Midway. In 1983, the Midway Stake was created. The very popular Midway Swiss Days celebration, which began in 1947, continues to celebrate the town's Swiss heritage each year. Some proceeds from those Swiss stays revenues have been donated each year to the church, from which much good has been accomplished. There are presently 8 stakes in the Heber City Area Coordinating Council, and more will come. This valley will continue to be a fruitful seedbed for devoted and dedicated members of the church. Now I'd like to speak about the history of this property on which the temple will be built. This story begins in 1910 with William and Annie Holmes, H-O-L-M-E-S. They lived in Plumtree, Nottinghamshire, England. Boarding with them in their home were 2 elders from the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. William and Annie were not members of the church, but they were motivated by these 2 young elders from America. William and Annie left their home and successful butcher shop, came to Midway with their 4 young children. Their son George Holmes, Sr., was born in Midway in 1914. They lovingly referred to him as Annie's little Yankee. George Sr. worked with his father and brother on the land in Midway and in Park City mines until World War II, when he reported for military duty in the Army. Prior to his leaving for scenes of war in the European theater, he married Clara Price from Midway. George Sr. was wounded in action in Germany. After recovery, he was sent home to be reunited with his wife, Clara. In 1946, George and Clara bought this property that is being dedicated today for a new temple in this gorgeous valley. George and Clara Holmes have since departed from mortality. Their 4 children, George P., Jane, Susan, and Glenn, and their families can now rejoice in the knowledge that the land originally purchased by their grandparents more than 76 years ago will fulfill George Sr.'s fondest dream. For years, he had dreamt of building a forever home with his beloved Clara. In a very real way, his dream will be realized here. You may recall that at the October 2021 General Conference, it was my privilege to announce plans to build a Heber Valley, Utah temple. Remember that? I thought you would. I was to be the 28th temple in Utah. The neighboring communities of Charleston, Walsburg, Camas, Oakley, Peoa, Park City, Colville, and parts of Wyoming will likely be included in the population base to be served by this temple. Today, we will begin the work by breaking ground for the temple in this unique and wonderful valley. I love you all and wholeheartedly rejoice with you. Now I invite you to bow your heads and join with me as I offer the dedicatory prayer on this special site. Our beloved Father in heaven, we thank thee for this inspiring and important event. We express our love for thee. We are grateful for thy love for us as thy covenant people. We thank thee for thy great plan of happiness. We thank thee for the gift of thy beloved Son, his mission and ministry. He is our Savior and Redeemer. His atonement has enabled us to return to thee with our companions and families. For these heavenly possibilities, we are deeply grateful. We love thy Son and revere him as our advocate and mediator with thee, our Holy Father. We thank thee for the restoration of the gospel of Jesus Christ in its fullness through the prophet Joseph Smith. We thank thee, O God, for that prophet. We thank thee for the Book of Mormon, the Doctrine and Covenants, other sacred scriptures, the restoration of priesthood authority, and the reality of continuing revelation from thee to thy servants and faithful children. We thank thee for faithful members throughout the world whose tithing finances the building and maintenance of all thy temples. Now, invoking the keys of priesthood authority, we hereby dedicate and consecrate this site for the building of the House of the Lord, the Heber Valley, Utah Temple. Dear Father, as we open this ground, we ask thee to bless this site and hallow it. We pray that the construction of this temple may be completed to accommodate thy divine purposes. We pray for thy protection upon all who will work on this project. May no harm or accident befall them. We pray that all who labor on this project will feel the importance of this great and sacred edifice, as it will house sacred ordinances and covenants of eternal significance. We pray that thou wilt thwart the efforts of any who might approach this site with ill intent. Beloved Father, we are deeply grateful for our ancestors. They have laid a foundation of faith that undergirds our spiritual strength. May we learn who they are, find their qualifying information, and bless their lives with sacred rites offered vicariously in this holy house. Each temple stands as a symbol of Jesus Christ, our mediator with thee, our Heavenly Father. Each temple stands as a sign of our faith in life after death, and as a sacred step toward eternal exaltation for us and our precious families. Please bless parents to teach their children about the Holy Temple. Please bless the leaders to help prepare men, women, and youth to participate in proxy ordinances here. Please bless the youth of this valley, that this temple may inspire them and give them courage to live worthy to enter its doors. Please bless the families of those who live in this temple district, that their bonds of affection may be strengthened and their devotion to thee increased. Please bless thy children here, that they may prepare to enter this holy house, make covenants with thee, and receive essential ordinances and blessings of this temple. May the building of this Heber Valley, Utah temple be a wonderful time of preparation and rededication in the lives of all who live in these precincts. May they literally become thy covenant people. As we dedicate this ground, we rededicate our lives to thee and to thy beloved Son. Humbly, we offer this prayer. In the sacred name of Jesus Christ, amen.